All right, Catherine Herridge was able to get to a camera for us. She's got the report in hand now. And Catherine, what do you conclude from it?
Well, just as at the table for folks at home, the Inspector General is the Justice Department's internal watchdog, and it's certainly not every day that the Inspector General is tasked with investigating the actions of a former FBI director who really sets the tone at the top of the Bureau for 35,000 people. And this report is lengthy, and it looks at three key issues. It looks at the issue of these memos that Comey took to document his conversations with the president, and he testified that he leaked some of those documents in order to kickstart the special counsel investigation. Some of those memos contain classified information, so the question before the Inspector General was whether he had mishandled classified information. That would have been a violation of 18 U.S.C. 793F. And just to show how things come full circle, that was the same statute that he investigated Hillary Clinton over for the mishandling of classified information. The second thing is whether he properly stored these memos. They were FBI government records. He took them outside of the FBI, and he held them at his home. And then he shared them with Columbia professor Daniel Rickman. He was a special government employee, which is a very unusual status for someone. He confirmed to us that it was unpaid. But he was the vehicle, if you will, for the leaking of these memos. And then finally, the thing to look for is whether Director Comey was straightforward with investigators about his actions on the memos. There's something in FBI speak calling lack of candor. That means the individual has spun their explanation and not been straightforward with investigators. And I'm going through the records right now, and already I see a pretty significant headline. You remember Director Comey, if you want to come back to me here one second and get off the file video. In this section on page 52, there's a very important headline from the Inspector General. When Director Comey testified, he said he felt these memos were his personal recollections of recorded events. But this is an explanation which does not satisfy the Inspector General. He states, Comey's characterization of the memos as personal records, this is important, finds no support in the law and is wholly incompatible with the plain language of the statutes. So in effect, he found Comey's explanation that he could take these records because they were like a diary or his personal memos or journals. That doesn't wash according to the Inspector General. His language, wholly incompatible with the statutes, and there's no support in the law. I'm going to continue reading here on the analysis. If I just
Catherine, if I find more, I'll come back to you. It went on after that to very clearly say, by definition, federal records include, quote, all recorded information, regardless of form or characteristics, made or received by a federal agency. Catherine, while you're digging through that, as we noted, James Comey had already responded on Twitter, quoting a portion of the report. He has just followed up with another tweet. I'll read it out loud. And to all those who have spent 2 years talking about me, quote, going to jail or being a, quote, liar and a leaker, ask yourselves why you still trust people who gave you bad info for so long, including the president. What does that tell you, Catherine, about the way James Comey is taking in this report?
Okay, so Comey's trying to get out in front of the investigation findings, and the reason he has so much insight into the findings is that the Inspector General gives the target of these investigations an opportunity to respond once the findings have neared their completion. So Director Comey has sort of a full aperture, if you will, into the findings of this report. But it doesn't change some of the, if I could say, cold hard facts of the findings here. On page 54, it states, Comey violated Department and FBI policies pertaining to the retention, handling, and dissemination of FBI records and information. That's important because, again, the statute, when it comes to the mishandling of classified information, shows no requirement for intent. And we know from FBI 302s, I have them here. These are FBI interviews with the former director. When they went to his home, he had four memos at his home, but then he told them that two were missing. So losing government records, if they were unclassified or classified, is a violation of the FBI policies and also, according to this report, his employment agreement, Sandra.
All right, Catherine Herridge on that breaking news for us this morning.